Good afternoon. Previous session, we learned about the outbreak of the revolution in the topic. So, we came to know that. So, the third estate representatives, about 600 representatives' demands were rejected by the monarch. And afterwards, actually, so they were all written back. They are walked out of the assembly to in protest. And afterwards, so the representatives of this third estate, so they were viewed themselves as spokesmen for the whole French nation. And 28th June, so and they were all assembled in the hall of the indoor tennis court of Versailles Palace. So they were declared themselves a national assembly. They were declared themselves and also swore not to disperse till they had drafted the constitution for France country, so which would limit the powers of monarch. So they were decided also like that, and about all this we learned in the previous class. See, after that what happened? The National Assembly, it was busy at Versailles Palace. So, while drafting the constitution, okay, and the rest of the France is seated with the turmoil. So, the same time, a severe winter had meant a bad harvest. So, because of the bad harvest, the price of bread, it was rose, and often bakers exploited the situation and hoarded supplies also. And after spending hours in the long queues at the bakery, a crowds of angry women stormed into the shops. At the same time, so the king was ordered troops to move into Paris. So on 14th July, the agitated crowd stormed and destroyed the Bastille prison. See, in the countryside, the rumor it was spread from village to village that the lords of the manor had hired bands of brigands who were on their way to destroy the ripe crops. So this is what actually the rumors, so which was spread throughout the countryside. Then after, caught in a frenzy of fear, peasants in several districts, they were seized hoes, pitchforks and attacked shutters. That's about the bungalows. Okay. And they looted, hoarded grain and burned down documents containing records and manorial dues. So the people, so they were revolt against and they were continued like this. So what and all they did know? So way to destroy the records. So when the caught during the time in a frenzy of fear. So peasants in a several district, so they were seized hoes and pitchforks, and also they were attacked the shutters. They looted, hoarded grain and burnt down the different documents, even the containing records and manorial dues and so. See, a large number of nobles fled from their homes. They were fled from their homes. Many of them migrating to neighboring countries also. So when the peasants, so they were start to attack, so the rest of the large number of the noble class people, so they were came out from their houses and they were migrating to the neighboring countries also to save themselves. See, faced with the power of his revolting subject, Louis XVI finally accorded recognition to the National Assembly and accepted principles that his powers would from now on be checked by a constitution. Now during this same time, what happened? So when the common people, they were revolt against the Louis XVI. So Louis XVI was finally accorded recognition to the National Assembly, and even so Louis XVI, he was accepted the principle that his power would from now on be checked by a constitution. So on the night of 4th August 1789, the Assembly passed a decree that is about abolishing the feudal system of obligations and taxes. So tithes were abolished and lands owned by the church were confiscated. As a result, the government acquired assets worth at least 2 billion livres. So this is all happened so after 14th July when they were start to attack. Even the King Louis also was accepted and he was recognized, and even his power goes under the supervision of the constitution. So on the night of 4th August 1789, so the Assembly, it was passed a decree also that is about abolishing the feudal system of obligations and taxes. See, tithes were abolished and lands owned by the church were confiscated. Then as a result, what happened? The government acquired assets worth at least 2 billion livres. So this all actually so continued this process in the France country during this time. So afterwards, France becomes a constitutional monarchy. France becomes constitutional monarch. See, what is mean by the constitutional monarchy? That means, so the monarch, it is going to be continued, but the same time, so the king was under the control of the constitution. That means, so king himself, so he could not take any decision without consulting the National Assembly. He was supervised by the constitution. So this is called as a constitutional monarch. See, the National Assembly completed the draft of the constitution in 1791. So in 1791, the constitution was drafted by the National Assembly, and its main object was to limit the powers of the monarch. So what was the main object of the constitution? No, so the main object of the constitution, that was to limit the powers of the monarch. See, these powers, instead of being concentrated in the hands of one person, so were now separated and assigned to different institutions. So before, how was that? The power, it was actually completely concentrated and centralized with the only one person. Now, according to the constitution, so now here, instead of the one person, so now were separated and assigned to different institutions. See, that is about what we are actually following, the different organs of the government in a democratic system. So it was introduced in France country during 1791 only. So now, according to that, the constitution, so the power of the king, it was divided and separated within the different institutions, so such as the legislature, the executive and the judiciary. These are actually, we all know that, so the present democratic system, so which we can observe as the different organs of the democratic system government. See, this we can observe in that only. It means in 1791 only, so when the constitutional monarchy, it was comes to follow in the France country during that time, so the power of the king, it was actually going to be controlled by these three, the different institutions, such as the legislature, the executive and the judiciary. See, this made France a constitutional monarchy. constitutional monarchy. So what is meant by, once again, constitutional monarchy means, of course, monarch is there. Raja prabhutva ide makkala, aadre rajana adhikara adu samvidhana baddhavagirutta. That is about the constitutional monarchy. So monarch is there, king is there. I mean, he was there, the 16th Louis, but he must follow the set of rules and regulations which were mentioned in the constitution. So himself, he was not allowed to take any decisions. So this actually, we can see the first time in the world, the democratic ideas, that is about the legislature, the executive and the judiciary. So it was actually established in the France country during 1791, and by this, the France, it was became a constitutional monarch. See, please observe the page number 10, which was given in the textbook. So, the political system, how it was worked under the constitutional monarch. So, now, Vandal there, judiciary is there. Then, there are voters also. Then, we have to please keep it in our mind. So, the voters are divided into who are going to vote, whether the right to suffrage provided for everybody? No. So, actually, the voters are only the active citizens. So, here, the vote, it was entitled only about the 4 millions of a population of 28 million. So, out of 28 million, so, only the 4 millions of people, they got right to suffrage. Understood? No. And the remaining, the passive citizens, so they do not have right to vote also. It is about 3 million men and even so women, children and youth below 25 years also. So there we can see the citizens, they were divided like this, active citizens and passive citizens. See, the citizens of the country, even though under the constitutional monarch, so the right to vote, it was not provided for the entire citizens of the country. So only the active citizens, so they were cast their votes, and in the judiciary part, and again, so the executive, and here the legislature also. So legislature here, it is even the legislature, it was called as the National Assembly. So before it was called as the Estate General. So afterwards, it was renamed as a National Assembly. So there were 745 members in the National Assembly. So that's actually, they were the part of the legislature. And afterwards, so the vote about the electors. So here, the about 4 million, they were going to elect the electors, around 50,000 men, and these 50,000 men, they were going to elect the 745 members, and these 745 members, so they were actually controlling the king, so by their veto power, by their veto power. So here, the king and his minister, so they were controlled by the National Assembly. Got it? So here, the constitution of 1791, so vested the power to make laws in the National Assembly. So now, according to the 1791 constitution, so the power of making a law that completely belongs to National Assembly, which was indirectly elected. So here, the National Assembly also, it was not directly elected by the people. So why? Because so only about 4 million citizens out of 28 million, so they were actually electing the 50,000 voters, electors. So these 50,000 electors, so they are choosing the members for the National Assembly. The total number of the National Assembly, it was about the 745 members. So these 745 members, so they were controlling the king and ministers. Okay, so then after the dear students, here the citizens, they were voted for a group for electors who in turn those the assembly. Okay, and not all citizens. So all citizens, they are not going to cast their vote. So here, who had the right to vote? Whether all citizens of the, no. Actually, only men above 25 years of age, and those who are paid taxes, and given, so at least 3 days of labor's wage. So, tax pay martakanta do atwa 3 dinada vetana yenide ashtu pay martakanta only men. So even above 25 years, so they were actually got the status of the active citizens. Okay, so only these active citizens, they were got right to choose their electors, right to choose their electors. See, that is in there. They were entitled to vote. Only those electors, those active citizens, so they were entitled to vote. Okay, not everyone. And the remaining men and all women, so they were classed as passive citizens. Then the rest of the people in the country, so they were classed as passive citizens. See, to qualify as an elector and then as a member of the assembly, a man had to belong to the highest bracket of taxpayers. Highest bracket of taxpayers. So who are going to pay the highest tax? So they are actually going to become the member of elector body, who are there about the 50,000 men. And these 50,000 men, so they were going to choose a representatives to the National Assembly, which we used to call as the legislature body of the France. So about 745 members. See, the constitution began with the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen. This is what we have to concentrate, and then we should know that the Declaration of Rights of Man and Woman. So the constitution, so it was began with this declaration. See, the rights such as the right to life, freedom of speech, and even freedom of opinion and equality before law. So these are all were established as natural and inalienable rights. Natural rights. So which were those rights? Are right to life, freedom of speech, and freedom of opinion, and equality before law. See, that is, they belong to each human being by birth and could not be taken away. So it was the duty of the state to protect each citizen's natural rights. And these rights were called as natural rights. Got it? No. So the natural rights were right to life, freedom of speech, and freedom of opinion, and equality before law. So actually the constitution, so it was began with the declaration of rights of the declaration of rights of man and citizen. So according to that, the declaration of rights of man and citizen, so there were so things mentioned. The first thing, men are born and remain free and equal in rights. So men are born and remain free and equal in rights. The aim of every political association is the preservation of the natural and inalienable rights of man. So these are liberty, property, security, and resistance to oppression. And the third important point, that is about the source of all sovereignty resides in the nation. So no group or individual may exercise authority that does not come from the people. And the fourth one is, liberty consists of the power to do whatever is not injurious to others. And the fifth point, that is about the law has the right to forbid only actions so that are injurious to society. And the next point, the law has the right to forbid only actions that are injurious to society. And the next one, law is the expression of the general will. So all citizens have the right to participate in its formation personally or through their representatives. All citizens are equal before it. Then no man may be accused, arrested, or detained except in cases determined by the law. Every citizen may speak, write, and print freely. He must take responsibility for the abuse of such liberty in cases determined by the law. So, and the next one, for the maintenance of the public force and for the expenses of administration, a common tax is indispensable. So, it must be assessed equally on all citizens in proportion to their means. And the last point, that is about, since property is a sacred and inviolable right, no one may be deprived of it unless a legally established public necessity requires it. In that case, a just compensation must be given in advance. So these are all actually the contents of the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizen. So about this, actually one of the journalists, so who she was criticized, that we are going to discuss in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.